Despite the high employment numbers, the National Economic and Development Authority recognizes the need to create more high-quality jobs. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says this should be prioritized if the country wants to pursue economic transformations. He also calls for stronger partnerships between the public and private sectors to expand skills development and opportunities in the country. Let's now talk to Joshua Mata, Secretary General of Labor Group Centro. Good afternoon, Joshua. Thanks for joining us.
Hi, good afternoon, Ron.
Hi, Joshua. We're talking about the unemployment rate falling in October. According to government figures, that's around 260,000 jobs that we're talking about. But in the bigger picture, do you consider this as significant? Do you consider this as a big improvement?
Well, it's a slight improvement, definitely, from what we had last month, you know? And it's quite an improvement if you compare it from last year. But if you look at the total number of or the total percentage of people who are underemployed and underutilized, you'll see that it's almost roughly around 20% paren. Mm-hmm. And that only proves that we are now back to the bad normal that we used to have before the pandemic. Mm-hmm. They told us after the pandemic that they will build back better. But now that we're opening up the economy, it is only expected that there will be jobs available out there. But as NEDA has said, the quality of jobs remains, there's a lot to be improved, you know, right, when it comes to the quality of jobs. You know? So one out of five Filipino workers being unproductive, that's really bad. And that, to me, is the structural problem that we've always had before the pandemic, and now we're back into that again.
Okay, I'll get back to that in a bit, but this improvement in the unemployment rate, what can you attribute that to, and how much can you attribute that to government action? Of course, there is the easing of restrictions from the pandemic, and there's greater mobility now. But were there any more additional government actions that possibly contributed to the fall of the unemployment rate?
That's unfortunately the problem. The whole thing is happening. These improvements that we're seeing is happening despite the inaction of the government. It's been several months now since the new government has taken over, the new administration has taken over. And it has yet to unveil clear policies on labor. Mm-hmm. No, and that's the reason why we've been asking for a dialogue with the president, because we feel that unless the government starts intervening in the economy, primarily through a public employment program, then we will not be able to mop up the kind of structural unemployment that we always have, which we seem to be getting again. No? Not to mention that because of inflation, workers have been clamoring now for wage increases for quite some time now. And the government is still not saying much about these things other than order the regional wage boards to review the wage levels that they have set. But that's not what's needed. What's needed is an across-the-board wage increase for all workers in the country.
Joshua, if you get that chance to talk to the president about this situation, and aside from just asking for wage increases, what are your proposals? What will you be presenting to the president for his consideration?
Well, the biggest proposal that we've been calling for has always been the public employment program. We believe that the private sector, the government should not rely solely on the private sector. And we don't think that the private sector can mop up the unemployment, the structural unemployment that we have. That requires government intervention now. And a public employment program that provides guaranteed jobs as well as guaranteed incomes for workers, and even wage subsidies for those working in the small and medium scale enterprises would do a lot in terms of providing more jobs to workers out there. Mm-hmm. That's crucial. No, unfortunately, the government is still very much into this narrow thinking that employment can only be generated by cooperating with the private sector, as we have heard from NEDA. Mm-hmm. That's only part of the problem, the part of the solution. The other part of the solution has to be government itself, because there are a lot of jobs out there that needs to be done, but the private sector will not do simply because they will not profit from out of it.
But do you think the government can afford to have this kind of a program, a public employment program, and employ more people from the country?
Why not? They can afford to provide confidential funds to a lot of agencies that doesn't need confidential funds. So why can't they provide why can't they allocate those resources to where it is actually needed, like, for example, providing jobs to our people?
Mm-hmm. Now, Centro, as you mentioned, is also while hoping for a better employment situation in the country, it has been asking, of course, for higher wages for workers. How much has Centro been asking, and how do you feel about the government's reaction to your call?
I think, well, first of all, we will support any moves to increase the wages of workers, because we think that we feel that any adjustment is going to be a step forward towards ensuring that people actually are provided the living wage. No? Mm-hmm. What we really feel is needed is for us to have a better wage setting mechanism. You know, the regional wage setting that we have been using for more than two decades now has obviously failed. Because can you imagine, there's so many minimum wage rates that we have in every region, so much so that it's almost impossible for government to actually monitor if employers are actually paying the right wages, no, based on the minimum wages that they have set. And damn it, I think it's more than 200 at this point in time. Mm-hmm. Now, so that's the first problem. We need to address the way we set our wages at this point in time. But the bigger problem for me is that people in government are still fixated on the idea that when you raise wages, you're actually creating inflation. That's completely debunked by the ILO in its recent study. No, and in fact, in our case, in the Philippine historical experience, every wage increases that we've had has always been a response, a long delayed response to inflation that has already eaten up a huge chunk of the workers' real wages. Like, for example, last month, workers lost at least 76 to 78 pesos simply because of the 7.7% inflation, right, that hit us, 8% na ngayon. Mm-hmm. So we're catching up with loss. We're trying to catch up and recoup lost wages at this point in time. So I think this whole notion that wages would lead to much more inflation is something that they have to stop using now.
Okay. Finally, Joshua, you mentioned extra funds a while ago when you talk about confidential funds. We want to get your thoughts about the Maharlika Wealth Fund being proposed by Congress. We want to hear from someone from the labor sector. What's your reaction to the creation of the fund?
Well, Centro, together with the entire labor movement, has been in opposition to this fund. We feel that this is grossly immoral, because can you imagine? Our lawmakers are talking about using pension funds of workers. That's not their money. What's their right to talk about our funds, no? They should not meddle with the pension funds of people from the public sector and the private sector, and then invest it in a way that would undermine the strict legal regulations that SSS and GSIS had. I've read the bill, and in one version, it actually says that whatever money that this fund gets, it will be able to invest it beyond the regulatory measures that the GSIS and SSS has been providing, which has kept our funds pretty safe, no, from speculative investments. Now we're going to subcontract, part of the fund, hand it over to this new entity called Maharlika, only so that they could play around with it and using our money and play, gamble our money in the global casino of speculative ventures. That's very dangerous. So they should not meddle with pension funds, and that's why we oppose this. Now, if they really, really want to create sovereign wealth funds, well, first they have to create the wealth, no? And that wealth is out there, only they're not collecting it. So the best way to do it, collect wealth tax from our billionaires, and they will get extra money, and that's what they can use and that's what they can use for these sovereign wealth funds that they're thinking about, but yes, not workers' pension funds, please.
Secretary General of Centro, Joshua Mata. Joshua, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ron.